Give me your tired, your poor, your huddled masses yearning to breathe free. The wretched refuse of your teeming shore, send these, the homeless, tempest-tossed to me. I lift my lamp aside the golden door. The Statue of Liberty has been a symbol of hope, a beacon to those seeking freedom. Today, there are 15 individuals who become citizens of our great nation. They hail from 12 countries: Benin, Brazil, Canada, Dominican Republic, Haiti, India, Iran, Jordan, Mexico, Philippines, Thailand, Trinidad, and Tobago. Today, their dreams of becoming an American citizen become reality. We as a nation are a better nation because of them. With them, we are stronger together. We are fortunate.
Some 80 years ago, a ship passed by the Statue of Liberty and pulled into Ellis Island. It was the port where all immigrants arrived into the United States. That ship had departed Naples, Italy, weeks before. And after that two-week journey, like many other ships, carried hundreds and hundreds of immigrants from Europe, all of whom sought entry into the United States of America, looking for freedom, a better life, a world of opportunity for them and for their children. There was a 9-year-old girl on that boat that day. She arrived with her mother and her sisters. She was met there by her father, who had arrived years earlier to pave the way. She did not know the customs. She could not speak the language. In fact, later that day, she was given a piece of fruit to eat, and she didn't know how to eat it. It was a banana, and she had never seen one before. So that little girl never became famous. She did not become a millionaire. She did not become president or governor or senator. What she did do was go to school. She learned the English language. She became a naturalized citizen, like all of you will be. During World War II, her husband, also of immigrant heritage, went off to duty on behalf of the United States Army in the Pacific Ocean. She remained here, working in the Philadelphia Naval Shipyard, helping build ships for the war effort. After the war, they saved their money and bought their first home. They made certain that their children had the opportunity to get a good education. And that little girl grew up to see her children grow up and marry and have children of their own. That woman was my mother. And she died on January 1st of this year, at the age of 100 years of age, having lived the American dream. She saw her son become a judge, and she was able to realize that there was success available to her, not by what she became, but what she made of it. I get this opportunity to welcome you as a new group of American citizens. And I do this on a day that is meaningful to me, and I hope that you realize the many benefits that she realized and avail yourself of the opportunities that she had. I will tell you the lesson that she learned being an American, and that she, by her example, taught me and her other children. America does not give you wealth. It does not give you knowledge, or honor, or position, or prestige. But America gives you the opportunity to achieve all and every one of those things. And you have the right and the freedom to pursue it. Seize that opportunity as new citizens. Take the opportunities that are available to you as citizens. And maybe like that 9-year-old girl who arrived in this country 80 years ago, you too will achieve the American dream. Thank you for allowing me to be a part of this ceremony.
Thank you. Stephen Elizabeth Sepp.
From its earliest days, settlers of what would become the United States referred to their new world as a city upon a hill. Through the years, many have continued to refer to America as a city upon a hill, meaning that they believe it is a beacon of hope to the world. I believe in this sentiment, but I do not believe that America serves as an example to the rest of the world in that it is a perfect union, a template of exceptionalism. Rather, America is exemplary through its citizens' continual struggle to attain this ideal. The march, step by step, and sometimes one step backwards before again going forward towards a nation of tolerance and compassion and equality. A defining characteristic of this country's uniqueness and progress is its diversity of its citizens. And the diversity of our citizenship stems directly from our immigrants. It is this diversity that makes America a beautiful blend of cultures, languages, and religions and ideas. My own family is a family of immigrants. My mother's side descended from England, Ireland, and Alsace-Lorraine. They came to America with dreams of a better life. My father's father followed the lead of his three brothers and immigrated to America in 1910, later opening a store on the main street of a small but growing Long Island town. He became involved in local politics and the Chamber of Commerce and lived his American dream of owning a business and supporting his family. You are all now part of this country's movement forward. The experiences you bring, the perseverance inherent in the challenges you faced to immigrate to this country, the desire you carry with you to make your mark on this nation. It is the passion that each of you bring with you right now and the diversity of experience, language, and culture that will continue to make this country that city. And to close our ceremony, I would ask you to rise for the Pledge of Allegiance. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Thank you so much.
Ladies and gentlemen, we are adjourned, and I thank the Bar Association and all who have participated. Congratulations, my fellow Americans.
Thank you.
Beautiful.
skies. For amber wings of grain. For purple mountains.